So whether you are greenhorn in data science or you are a veteran in it, doesn't matter. Data science always deals with bias and variance trade. So you must understand what is bias, what is variance, when to use and how to control these things. But what is it? So let's dive into what is it, bias, variance, how to deal with it, and what are the all aspects? What are the things like? What do you need to know? What is it? How it is? Every aspect in a very brief and short manner. Let's dive in. Let me share my screen. In the meanwhile, you can hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, share your comments, share your feedback. All right, today's topic is bias versus variance. Hi. So if you search about bias variance, this is the first thing you get to see. What is it? So over here we have, what do you say, high bias over there. Basically, it's a combination, 2x2 combination of bias and variance. So you have low variance, high variance, and you have low bias, high bias. Nice. So let me share my pointer. Over here, low variance, low bias. You can see, imagine this is a dart game, right? This is a dart game. You are throwing the darts and it's hitting bullseye every time. So whosoever the player is, you would say the player is a perfect one. So this is the case of a perfect model, right? Now let's have a look at it. What is it? It is labeled as overfitting. This one is labeled as underfitting. This one is not labeled. But whatever it is, we will not get into the depth of it at this moment. We'll rather switch to something better. But have a look at it. So basically, you have a dart. The model is throwing. Let's say you ask the model to throw the darts. Model is throwing and hitting the bullseye every time. Every time. So what do you say? Well, you say it's a low bias, low variance model, or a perfectly fit model. Over here, if the bias is high and the variance is low, you would say it's underfitting. Bias, variance is high, bias is low, you would say overfitting. None is the case, everything is high, you would say badly fitting. But whatever it is, neither do you understand what I said, neither do I, neither should I. Had I been in your place, I wouldn't have. So let's proceed forward. A picture which is quite similar to this is this one. Picture which is quite similar to that is this particular one. And what does this tell about? This tell about accuracy and precision in a very, very similar manner to the previous one. So if it hits the bullseye, we'll say that it's a highly accurate and highly precise model. Same goes with underfitting. This is underfitting, not accurate but very precise. We'll say accurate but precise, not accurate, not precise. Still not clear. Let's proceed. So till now, we have not understood anything. We just seen whatever the internet tries to show us. We have not understood anything. Just internet, whatever internet tries to show us, we have just taken it and just had a look. But there are four possible combinations. All right. First is low bias, low variance. This must be very, very much clear. This is just very much. This is very logical, right? This is permutation and combination. So what it is, you have. Bias has two possibilities. Either it can be high, it can be low. Variance can be high, it can be low. So low bias, low variance, low bias, high variance. Then you have high bias, low variance, and high bias, high variance, whatever it is. So all the four possible combinations. But before we begin, there are two types of ML models which we usually talk about, and that is linear ML models and non-linear ML models. Linear models are usually the regression models. Non-linear models are the kernel methods or the tree methods. Why? Why am I talking about this? It's about complexity. It's about complexity. So every time anybody asks you about what is bias and variance trade-off, always remember bias and variance trade-off is nothing but model simplicity and model complexity trade-off. you always trade off between how simple the model is and how complex the model is. How simple the model is and how complex the model is. So the model can needs to be simple, but needs to have some complexity. If too complex, it would be overfitting. If too simple, it would be generic. You get my point? Now, simplicity is parallel to bias. Complexity is parallel to variance. So, if the model has high simplicity, high bias, so model does not like, would not be able to perform even on the training data. Now, second point, which people usually never mention, bias is usually concerned with your training error or training performance. Variance is usually concerned with your testing or dev error or the variance error, or sorry, validation error, the validation error. So, if I say you have a low bias, what would I mean? That the model is not overly simple, is not overly generalized. So, if the model is not overly generalized, it understands what the training data set. So just imagine this, like a data set of points, like it starts from in a curvilinear manner. One point over here. One way is just a simple straight line. Might be a good representative, not the perfect one. So we would say high bias. Perfect one would be something like this. Right? So this is how you deal with bias. Now variance. Variance is like how much are you incorporating the deviation in the data set. So if your data, one point is over here. So you do not need to go in a zigzag manner, rather take an average path. So you take an average path, that's a good representative. So that is how variance is talked about. Main measure of variance is usually your testing performance. Low variance is like you're not too much into getting nitpicking. You are basically not nitpicking the data set. You're trying to understand the overall aspect. You're not overly making the model complicated. You are making the model complicated to the extent it is needed. Still not clear, not an issue. So this is a graph which is usually shown that there's an error, there's a model complexity. So it's all about model complexity and simplicity, bias, variance. Now as the complexity increases, initially we have high bias for a very simple model. A model in this particular region is very simple with low complexity would be said to have high bias. A model in this region is now very complex, extremely complex, so would be performing. So complexity in the sense learns the training data very well. So would not be able to generalize, and generalizing ability decreases. Would be able to generalize a lot, but wouldn't be able to learn. Hasn't learned anything, that's why is able to generalize. So hasn't learned anything and is able to generalize, rather overly generalizes. And this is the, so is not performing good even in the training data, because you have not understood the training data. Over here, you've understood the training data, but to a more than required. You've understood the training data to an extent it is more than required, which leads to a high performance on the training data, but a very poor performance on the validation data, which means we are looking for something intermediate, where the bias is also good and the variance is also good. So now we have understood, okay, so bias has one problem like overly generalizes. So training data is not learned, and variance, so bias problem is when you have not, the model has not even understood what the training data is, overly simple, like a simple regression model for a very complicated task. A best example is you always use a baseline of regression or logistic regression for your Kaggle competitions or anything. So that is the case of by saying. So you start with a very overly simple model, and variance is like you are using 100 RF and sampling bagging, so that is overfitting, that is the variancing. So you would love to have a sweet spot. It is not exactly high bias, overly, it's not overly simple and it's not overly complex on the training data. It justifies the training data to the extent it is needed, right? So dealing with the bias problem, so there are two aspects. Either it can have low bias or it can have high bias. Low bias is a good thing. Models with low bias are usually the ones which are complex ones. So trees, KNN, SVM. High bias, what does it mean? High bias is overly simple. Overly simple hasn't even understood what a training data provides. So low training accuracy. Okay, so how do you deal? Basically, bias problem is how do you deal with training accuracy? How do you improvise your training accuracy? No matter what your testing accuracy is, your training accuracy is dull. So no, you have not even understood what the training model has not even understood what the training data provides. And the model has not even understood what the training data provides. First, it needs to make its expertise on the training data. So, remedy. Increase the model complexity. Add more features or cardinality. Make the model more complex. That's it. Adding data doesn't help here. Adding data would not help. Might help, might not help. Because it's not the data which is at fault. It is the model or the approach which is at fault. So, if your training accuracy is significantly low, then it's a case of underfitting, which is this underfitting or this. This is the worst case scenario. This is the worst case scenario. So your training, this is like, okay, training performance is low, is around 74, 75. So is the validation performance. So whatever is learned is precisely learned. Like, okay, whatever the model has learned, there's no flaw in it. So this is the case of underfitting, where is high accuracy and precision. No, not accurate, but very precise. But this is the case when it has not even learned anything. So variance is high, bias is high, everything is high. Let's go with bias or variance problem. What is variance thing? So it's a like low variance good thing. Model examples, linear regression, LDA, logistic regression, high variance. What is high variance? When your testing error is very high. So let's say your training performance, training error is 5%, but your testing performance is 10% or 15%. Then you say it's overfitting, absolutely overfitting. And how do you deal with that? So maybe the testing data is quite shifted, drifted from your training data. And what do? You add training data, improvise it so that it is covering all the aspects. Or you simplify the model, or you use bagging approaches. So this is what we are about to see. So no matter what it is, there would be some inherent error. Some inherent error, this is the error curve. Total error, this is there. So we cannot obtain this. This is just a hit and trial. So you made one model, made one approach, it was over here. Alright, so what it had very high bias and was overly simple, training accuracy was poor. So once you observe training accuracy is poor, you improvise the model complexity. Now the model is overly complex, you stand over here. So training performance is good, extremely good, but now variance has increased. You start adding data, you now reach over here. So such permutation combinations of all the possibilities end up being a plot like this. And therefore, you need to select the sweet spot wherein the variance and the bias are minimum. You cannot eliminate those, but can achieve a pseudo minimal, which is not to be cannot be calculated, but can be intuited. So this is it. Entirely it. Bias versus variance, basically model complexity and model simplicity. How do you control it? Is basically how do you control underfitting, overfitting? If it is high bias, high variance, there's no point of it. It's like a poor model is absurdly bogus. But if you have, it's always a deal off between how complex your model is and how simple your model is. Should not be overly complex, should not be overly simple. I hope this justifies and clarifies the concept to a great extent. And if you have any doubt and concern regarding this, please hit me in the comment section. Hope you're doing well. Take care. Bye-bye.